The cherry blossom trees in San Diego at the Japanese Friendship Garden in Balboa Park. I'm Chris, this is Yellow Productions. I do travel guides that are fun, informative, and entertaining. And in this video, I'm gonna be showing you these amazing cherry blossoms in this amazing Japanese garden. It's located in Balboa Park, which is in the center of San Diego. It's right next to the Oregon Pavilion. So if you're coming here, the best place to park is the Oregon Pavilion parking lot. Admission, $10 to $12, depending upon whether you're a senior, student, military, or general admission, but it's well worth it to come in. There are 300 cherry blossom trees here. Most of them were planted fairly recently in 2015, so they're pretty young. You can tell this is a pretty young tree. They bloom in March and April. This year in 2019, they are in full bloom. Today, March 27th, 2019. They're a pretty spectacular place to come and admire these trees because there's not a lot of places in Southern California that you can come to see this many cherry blossom trees all in one place. But if you're not here just for cherry blossoms, like what if you're not here in March and April? Is it still worthwhile to come to the Japanese Friendship Garden? I think it is because there's lots of neat other Japanese elements to this garden. It is a very nice, well-maintained Japanese garden. That $10 to $12 that you pay to come in, you might think it sounds expensive, but they spend it on maintaining this place. It's well-maintained. They do gardening in the traditional Japanese way, by hand, with scissors and snips. No power tools, no leaf blowers. There's plenty of benches you could sit around. They've got all these really neat koi ponds that you can like admire, these really big goldfish. You can hear the streams. They've got this statue over there that's from Japan from the year 1735. That's really cool. But because these trees are new, the cherry blossom trees are new, they've got this little tree over there. They call it the peace tree. It's like the ginkgo tree. It was also planted in 2015. It's like about this big. I'm sure this tree will be big and spectacular at some point in the future. It's got a few different parts to the garden. There's the upper garden as you first come in. The upper garden, right as you pay your admission, there's a little gift shop. You can bring home some cherry blossom souvenirs, but you could also take home your very own cherry blossom tree. Just $175. The name of the garden on the rock by the entrance is called Sankai-en. It's the same name as a garden in Yokohama, Japan, which means three-scene garden for water, pastures, and mountains. Also next to the front gate is this little place called Tea and Eats. It's got tea and it's got eats. Actually, it's called the Tea Pavilion, but now you know what they serve. I don't know that I would recommend. The food is looking super delicious, but in Balboa Park, if you're hungry, you don't have a lot of options. But really where the action is the lower garden. You'll pass through this really neat gate that'll take you down some steps. It is handicapped accessible, so they have ramps as well to bring you down here where the cherry blossom trees are. And I will say, these cherry blossom trees, they're really awesome to take pictures around, but this garden, it's just a tranquil, peaceful place. There's lots of things that bloom different times of the year. One of my favorite things, they don't bloom, they're all year round, are the bonsai trees. They've got a really neat bonsai tree exhibit. I just love how miniature they are. And you can tell they really take care of the trees here, like the cypress tree they have. They've actually got it up on a post so that the cypress tree is just, it's held up, right? So that it doesn't fall down, so they can craft these trees into interesting things. But because I mentioned this place is new, these trees are young, and so they're not as big and spectacular as maybe in Washington, D.C. or even in Japan, but every year they're just gonna get better and better. As you stroll along the path, you'll come across a Japanese-looking house. Inside this house, special exhibit today, a pottery exhibit. But they've got this really neat seating area where you can sit and admire the Japanese rock garden. Very zen. In addition to the main path, they've got these little side paths that you can take around the koi ponds. This is pretty cool because you can get kind of away from the crowd, see things, and be here in the middle of the koi pond. You could imagine, if this was a picture, that this would make a very zen picture, wouldn't it? But it's pretty neat, and this is something that you'll often find in the traditional Japanese gardens that I love that they recreated this. Here, all the way at the bottom of the canyon, they have the Inamori Pavilion, which you can rent for special events. There's bathrooms down here, and they're planning to build a tea house in the future. So when you come, you might be able to get some nice tea down here by the koi pond. In addition to statues made in Japan, they've got some traditional stone lanterns that are made in Japan. This one here is 9 feet tall. This was built in the city of Okazaki in Japan, a city that's famous for its traditional stone products. So not only is it reminiscent of Japan, lots of things here are from Japan. So if you are in San Diego and you are in Balboa Park, definitely check out the Japanese Friendship Garden, particularly for cherry blossom season. But any time of the year would be great. Hey, and if you're coming to San Diego, this is part of my series on San Diego. I've got a video about things to know in San Diego, what the best beaches are in San Diego. You can click right here to watch them or find links in the description below to my full playlist on San Diego. Well, I won't say goodbye because I'll see you in one of these videos.